The Holy Spirit is the one that performs the operation of regeneration. And in a flash, it's you.
Just a Cog in the Wheel. By Andrew Gilbert Smith. I had a dream a while back that had a very surreal connotation to it. I wrote a piece about it titled It Will Be a Shocking Experience. I do believe that the truth I derived from that dream about the power structures coming down is within the correct genre of interpretation, but has many layers of proclamation within that statement. The different layers of revelation range from physical manifestation to spiritual truth and encompass everything in between. Recently I had another dream that had the exact same ambience and graphic notation. It was like a different scene from the same movie. Without a doubt, this second dream was a sequel. I am going to share the first dream again and then try to explain the second dream. I am going to try my best to extrapolate from my very center the significance of the two dreams and the bell that they ring within that center. First dream. It starts off with a huge concussion explosion that rocked the entire house. We all run outside to see what is going on. There is a massive fireball rolling up into the air and the explosions keep rocking us with sonic blasts. It pops into my head in the dream that the explosions are coming from the general direction of the local church my family and I attend. With a curious inflection, we hopped in the truck and went rubberneckin'. The strange part was there wasn't any panic amongst us as to the situation, but a sense that we needed to get there before we missed something significant that was happening. As we approached the hill where the church comes into view, we realized that it is indeed our church and the flames were massive. We looked at it in complete awe. There was no despair but a real sense of wow. As we pulled up to the turn in, I noticed a twin set of those high tension power line towers, the really big ones with the giant arms that were just ominously hovering over us. They are not there in reality but only in the dream. The intense heat from the flames had heated the metal frame structure of the power line tower so much it had begun to wilt under its own weight. As it crashes into the second tower, sparks fly and they both fall. The sounds of iron creaking and squalling during the descent and then the crash as it lands across the highway. The sounds of cables clashing and breaking all around us. Next thing I remember, I am sifting through cinders of the burned out church. The walls were gone as if an internal explosion had disintegrated them. I see my pastor Jeff picking something up and brushing off the soot and smiling as if collecting a souvenir from a very significant event. Second dream. I am in giant field of grass. There are people there and we are pointing and discussing something about this field. My work truck is there with a ladder rack full of ladders and toolboxes full of tools. This has been a common scene in my life due to the nature of my employment and the years I have spent in the contracting and building field. I knew that the discussions taking place had to do with building something in this field. Then very abruptly a sound arrived. Very loud and very close. Whomp, 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 whomp. It sounded much like the engines of the pod racers in the Star Wars movie Phantom Menace when they would crash and the jets were winding down. The sound directed my attention to my left, where I saw a jumbo jet in a distressful fight to stay in the air. It emerged from the clouds and smoke as if it was unnoticed until it was right upon us. It was close enough that I even moved back as if to dodge a punch just to keep it from hitting me. It passes by and continues its descent and eventually crashes just over the horizon of this field. The shape of the field and the perspective of the dream rendered that horizon very close but just out of sight. The explosion had the exact sound, graphics, and concussion of the explosions of the first dream. Very quickly I heard the sound of the iron creaking and squalling just like the first dream. As if the sound of the first dream had been dubbed over these new graphics. The squeaking and noise of the distressed iron directed my attention forward facing where I saw a giant fire truck ladder with firefighters on it. The ladder was swinging through the clouds and black smoke as if it had been purposely tossed away from its efforts to control the blaze. As gravity took hold of the giant ladder and it began to fall toward the left, I seen what looked like a four-wheel drive gene boom that had just been flipped by some massive force. The basket and the boom hit the ground with such force that the ground exploded in a concussive blast of dirt and firefighters. Then just a little to my left I saw a figure beginning to emerge from the smoke and ash. This figure had the frame of a very large man wearing leather pants and a leather jacket, both black. His features reminded me of Damien from the movie The Mask when he put on the mask, except instead of green his face was red and marbled with soot and looked like cooling molten rock. He walked past me with absolutely no acknowledgement of my presence. There was an entourage following him. As he passed, he was expressing his contempt for this place that he had just arrived at and was mumbling his plans for its demise to the following entourage. That was the end of the dream. I told a few people about the second dream. My friend Austin and my kids. There was a video I came across of a lady that was sharing her dream about a clock she had seen in heaven. This brought attention to me the graphic I had made for my series I wrote titled As the Pendulum Swings. There is a watch in this graphic and behind the hands of the watch you can see the individual cogs and wheels that keep the time. This writing came to fruition only due to a very loud ringing in my center. I have come to terms with the fact that this is one of the things I am supposed to proclaim, the coming harbinger. The red dragon. I believe the figure that comes out of the smoke is indicative of that giant red celestial body that will make itself known very soon. It is, however, only part of what is coming and is but only a tool of the Creator. A tool of judgment and purification of the wicked systems of this world and the powers and principalities that rule it. The power structure of this age is about to be taken down. The political climate is but a manifestation in the natural of the oncoming truth about to be revealed and the power structure that is about to change. The power generation of this civilized age that is about to implode is but a manifestation of the spiritual truth that is prevalent under the veil. It is a faint echo of the collapse of the witchcraft and transmutation systems used by the powers of darkness to siphon the life force of fallen angels and people to use it to fuel the armies of that darkness to wage war on the Creator Himself. Oh yes, everything in this natural realm is but an echo of the truth that lies underneath. Men will attempt to fight this harbinger by means of their own knowledge and resources only to look feeble and foolish in the wake of its arrival. The only hope for anyone is to recognize the sovereignty of the one that wields the iron rod. Revelation 2:27-29, KJV, 27 And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father. 28 And I will give him the morning star. 29 He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. Revelation 12:5, KJV, 5 And she brought forth a man-child, who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up unto God, and to his throne. Revelation 18:1-5, KJV, 18 And after these things I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory. 2 And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the great is fallen, and is become the habitation of devils, and the hold of every foul spirit, and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird. 3 For all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth are waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies. 4 And I heard another voice from heaven, saying, Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. 5 For her sins have reached unto heaven, and God hath remembered her iniquities. I am pretty sure there will be a third dream, a final scene to the movie that solidifies their purpose and meaning. There has been triality in most if not all impartations received spiritually. When that moment comes, I will indeed extend the content herein. Until then I will look to sky in anticipation and lamentation as I await the great day of our Lord that is set in motion by a cog in the wheel. Update April 23, 2017. Okay, so the third dream came in. Was not expecting the change of theme because this one was water-based instead of fire, but it was no doubt a sequel. The ambience and feel was exactly the same. Third dream starts off with mundane goodbye chatter as me and my cousin Chad exit the house to go somewhere. His truck is parked parallel to the house in what would be the flower garden. As we attempt to get in the truck, we begin to hear the rumblings of a very large storm. Wind, rain, and hail begin to come on at a slow but increasing rate. Then out of nowhere there was the spray and force of a giant wave that crashed in the distance. The wind, spray, and inertial force from the consummation of the wave blasted from between the houses across the street and gave a clear understanding that we were not going anywhere. The sound that it made when the sea spray blasted through was like that of a whale's blowhole exhaling. We go back inside and watch the next wave swell up. It breaks and crashes directly behind the houses across the street, and this time the water itself burst from in between the houses and reached our house with quite a powerful force. There is absolutely no way any house could withstand the hydraulic forces of waves this big, but the house was taking it. At one point, I mentioned maybe taking cover, but my wife was like, "Meh, it will pass." This is not indicative of my wife. When it thunders, she needs a thunder buddy in real life, ha ha ha. She was sitting on the couch that is in front of the wall that was taking the blasts from the waves. One rolled in and was the closest one yet, and when it hit the side of the house the entire wall warped like rubber as it absorbed the shock and the house rocked like a boat. Then my wife, in agreement that things were getting a little intense, we got behind the kitchen counter for shelter. Still able to see out of the window, I see the neighbor's house was cracked in two and was kind split open. Not destroyed, just broken into two pieces. Then the dream ends. There was never any real panic from any of us. Just casual conversation about the giant oceanic waves that were crashing into our house in central KYLOL. This dream brought up in my remembrance a word that was given to me 3 years ago that was one of three. It was the only statement of the three where the other two were answers to a question. Here is the word. God is about to lose the keys to his kingdom to the masses. A cultural paradigm shift. A tsunami of God's Holy Spirit will wash over mankind. As thought patterns change, words and language will rearrange and fall in line with his will. Principalities on earth will shift, and those in positions of influence will line up with the Spirit of God and his will and divine will. Heaven is coming.
May the grace of Christ, the love of Creator, and fellowship with the Holy Spirit be with you all.